friends, and welcome back to the Pastor's Study, where we are committed to helping you get to know your Bible better. My apologies to those of you tuning in this week hoping to hear us wrap up our series on the signs in the Gospel according to John. Next week we'll come out with a video on John chapter 11 where we talk about the raising of Lazarus, the final sign Jesus performed during his earthly ministry to demonstrate who he was, what he was about, and who we are supposed to be about as his followers. What I wanted to do this week, though, is to come to you to let you know where we're going to be going from here. In all of these videos from the Pastor's Study so far, we have talked about the Scriptures. In particular, we've really honed in on the Gospels and their significance for our life as followers of Jesus. What we're going to be doing is going to be a little bit different. You see, the First Christian Church of Lawton is part of a group of churches called the Christian Church Disciples of Christ. It's a movement, and this movement was started with four basic centering principles. Over the course of the next four videos, we are going to be discussing these four central principles that were absolutely imperative to the founders of this movement. We're going to look at them, and we're going to look at them with an eye toward how do we, in this day and age, take these ideas and still draw fresh power and strength from them? How do we look at them and reappropriate them for our situation in the world today? Finally, we will look at this idea of the Christian Church Disciples of Christ as a movement for wholeness in a fragmented world, and we'll tease out some of the concepts behind what it means to be a part of this amazing movement that God has originated. So I really do hope to see you back in the coming weeks as you join us for this exciting study. Next week, we'll be back with John chapter 11 as we look at Jesus's last sign, the raising of Lazarus. Then we'll be moving on to a look at the history, the theology, and some of the thought behind what makes us unique and distinct as Christians within the greater body of global Christianity. So I look forward to seeing you there. For now, goodbye, and God bless.